what we have, and I think I don't have time to cover other stuff, but you know, you can write a JavaScript extension in the sense that you know, is it still going? Let me cancel this. Okay, so so what you, so for example over here, you know, we saw various you know, command that I can write. Let us say I wanted to write a command to generate random numbers. So I, you know, have this, I've generated my own command called random generator. You know, there's a small JavaScript file that need to be written, and you know, I have to give the path of those extensions over here, right? And then, you know, I can run the commands, my own commands from here. So I can generate my own Selenium commands. You can have, you know, so Selenium provides APIs to capture screenshots. So for example, let's say, you know, the whatever test step I do, and after that I want to capture the screenshot, I can do that. Or, you know, I can want to, you know, capture the video of the sequence of steps, so I can do that. There are, you know, APIs available to do that. And you know, you can do data driven testing by using these frameworks like JUnit and TestNG. And since, you know, for example, let's say if you are working with Java, and inside the Eclipse IDE you can have you know, jar files which enable you to access an Excel file, and then, you know, you can read the rows and columns through that, get the data pairs and run them against your script. So for example, on login page, you want to have various combinations of user ID and password for testing. So you can store those combinations in an Excel file, and then read through you know, your Java program these using the Excel reading jar files through these Excel files, and pass them on to your test automation script. So so that enables your data driven testing. Okay, so quick questions, maybe a couple of minutes, and then you know, we can move on to a small quiz. Okay, do we have some questions? Okay, let me just open up the question. Okay, give me some time. Let me, all right. Okay, the question, one of the questions is that I know that Selenium requires programming expertise. Don't you think that that's a barrier to adoption in team dominated by manual testers? You know, I've already shared with you the challenges that you will you know, face if you rely too much of on manual testing, especially in web application scenario. So you know, you will have to learn you know, how to use this tool. Take help from your peer, you know, testers who know automation, or your peer developers. So, so that will, you know, enable you to contribute effectively into the team and move faster. Okay. Okay. Let me take some other ones. Just hold on. There's a question on Selenium for iOS for mobile. I'm not sure about the iOS part, but yes, there is a Selenium version for you know, the Android, so you can use that. Okay. Can we use Selenium IDE without Firefox? No, you cannot use Selenium IDE without Firefox. It comes as a, you know, plugin for Selenium IDE only. Can we customize Selenium to take screenshot of web pages at various checkpoints? Yes, you can do that, Masood Aftab. There are APIs available to do that. Chandakant Premdas, can we use Selenium to test mobile apps? Yes, you can do that. And as I shared, you know, Selenium version for Android is available. Okay, another question is, what changes are to be done? This is from Harish Kumar K. What changes are to be done to Eclipse to use Selenium RC? No changes are to be done to the Eclipse. You just have to install the corresponding you know test framework that you want to use. For example, you know JUnit or TestNG. Even otherwise, if you want to you know straight away write a Java project, you can do that. It's just that you have to add the corresponding jar files. That is, you know. The Selenium jar files in your projects, and that will give you access to creating Selenium objects and run the tests. All right, so I think that's all I have time to take the questions. So let's move forward quickly, and maybe if I have a little bit more time left, then you know we'll take up some more questions. But I have some questions for you. And these questions are so. First is you know why is Selenium called Selenium? So as I shared with you, Selenium is a element in periodic table, and it is used to cure mercury poisoning. So they started to refer to it as Selenium because mercury came with a tool called QTP, and Selenium was an open source tool. What is Selenis? So Selenis are the Selenium commands which are there in the script. What does RC in Selenium stand for? So RC in Selenium stands for Selenium RC stand for remote control. Is distributed test execution environment supported in Selenium? Yes. And what is it called? It's called the Selenium Grid. Can you write test in any popular programming language and run it on Selenium? Yes, you can do that. I have already answered this. What is the other name for Selenium WebDriver? So yeah, that's right. It's Selenium 2.0. And is Selenium open source? Yes, it's an open source tool. Okay, and you know this is the location for the course which is available on Selenium automation. Let me just share it with you. So let me just one second. So this is the Selenium automation course which is available. And if you want to know more about this course, you know, you can have you can give your name, email and contact, and somebody from TechGeek can reach out to you and explain. And you know it basically covers everything related to Selenium and will help you get started on you know Selenium automation. Okay, and of course there is this course on the software testing. So for those of you who want to you know brush up your knowledge on software testing, or if you have not done any formal training on software testing, so this is available at techgeek.com/ecourses. Here are my contact details, my email ID, the Test to Best community Facebook page, Google group, and its website. You can find me on TechGeek, Facebook, LinkedIn as Ganesh Sahai, and on Twitter as GSahai. And of course, you know, my new training and services venture, quiztrain.com. Okay, thank you very much. I hope this webinar has been of value to you. And, you know, let's keep learning whatever news coming our way. Thank you very much. And